Can you believe I ran out of gas? Good thing there's a gas pump right here. Hey, wait a minute. This is not a gas pump.
Hey, Jack.
Hey, Mike.
You having a little trouble there?
Yeah.
This is an electric charging station.
Wait, you guys have a lot of those electric cars here?
We sure do. Oh, let's go take a look.
All right, let's go.
With longer range batteries and more places to charge, electric cars are becoming a popular choice for drivers who want to reduce their consumption of fossil fuels.
This is the Consumer Reports garage. This is where we keep all of our hybrid and electric vehicles. So let's take a look at an electric car. Unlike a gasoline engine, this has an electric motor that's powered by a battery pack, and that's the entire floor of this car is the battery.
So how does a car battery like this work?
So this is a lithium ion battery, and it needs to be recharged, and it's kind of like in your cell phone, if you have one of those same batteries.
Can you plug this in just anywhere?
Yes and no. You can plug in it at home, but it's best if you have a fast charging system because it'll charge much more quickly. You're talking just a few hours rather than overnight.
So how often then do you have to recharge this car battery?
Depends on the range of the electric car. In this case, this has a longer range battery. You're looking at 200, 250 miles of range. But if you're on a trip, like I just came back from my cabin that was 10 hours away, I'd have to stop multiple times to charge. And even if you can find a fast charging station, you're looking at least 45 minutes of waiting for the car to charge. And you have to find those systems.
So electric cars are good for people who want to save money on gas and are environmentally conscious, but they're not the only option for drivers wanting to limit their dependence on fossil fuels.
So if you don't want to deal with constantly recharging, you can take a look at a more traditional hybrid.
How does a hybrid system work?
So it's a combination of a gasoline engine with an electric motor, and they work in conjunction to provide the most efficiency possible.
So how is this system able to save so much fuel?
So it uses the electric motor when it's most efficient to do that, which is predominantly in the city. And it uses the gasoline engine on the highway because that's when the gasoline engine is most efficient. And if you want full throttle, then usually they will work together. And it's constantly switching back and forth between electric motor and gasoline engine and regenerating braking power for the battery pack.
According to Mike, when you hit the brakes in your car, energy is wasted. A hybrid car's regenerative braking system captures that energy for the car to use.
It sounds like a great car, so why isn't every car a hybrid?
They're a little more expensive than regular gasoline cars, and because they're designed for efficiency, they really aren't all about power. So they're not exactly the fastest car out there.
So hybrids are great for people who drive a lot in stop-and-go traffic, like in a city or a busy suburb.
So you've got your regular hybrid here, you've got an electric car here. I want to show you something else. This is a hybrid minivan, but with a twist.
What's the twist?
Check it out. You plug it in just like an electric car. So this is what's called a plug-in hybrid. So I just take the plug off the wall, bring it back, and I'm going to plug it into the car.
What's the difference between a hybrid and a plug-in hybrid?
Well, the beauty of plugging it in is you've got a bigger battery pack than a regular hybrid. So it gives you the ability to go 20 to 50 miles on pure electric power.
So you got gas, electric, hybrid, and plug-in hybrid. I'm wondering, what's the alternative fuel of the future?
We test all kinds of alternative fuel vehicles here, and one of the most cutting edge we've tested is what's called a fuel cell vehicle, which runs on hydrogen. Now, with that, it doesn't have any exhaust emissions, just a little bit of water vapor.
How do you turn hydrogen into fuel?
It uses what's called a hydrogen stack to convert oxygen and hydrogen into electricity to power the electric motor, because really, it's kind of like an electric car, just with a different power source. So the downside is, this is basically like space age technology. So these are very expensive cars, and there isn't an infrastructure that's really built up yet in this country, so it's hard to refuel the car.
Mike, you filled me with a lot of information, but my car's still out of gas.
Oh, that's a good point. Let's hop in this high-tech rig, and I'll see if I can get you home.
I appreciate it, man.